team should have shaken the rust off by now. Hello, I'm Anthony Hudson. And joining me in the box for some special comments will be Gary Lyon.
Hi, Hutto. Always a pleasure to call a game with you. Still an interesting prospect at the moment. Unsure what these sides will deliver this season, but hopefully today we should see more of an indication.
Here today, the clash between the Dockers and Carlton. They run on in full confidence. They're looking sharp, and the crowd are appreciating it. The cheer squad's hard work is paying off. The banners are looking great.
It's a big midfield battle today. Whichever team can get on top in the middle of the ground will walk out winners today.
Here come Freeman. I'm really looking forward to seeing how they play today.
You're right, Hutto.
The captains make their way to the centre circle for the coin toss. Fremantle kicking to the right of screen. Just waiting for the opening siren now. And here we go. It's Fremantle taking on Carlton. With the ball now. Pittenet read it best. Darcy couldn't complete the tackle. Lobs the handball. The loose ball picked up. Hogan controlled the difficult ball. Chalked a goal off the Freeman. Matera celebrates with the fans. The first goal of the match.
It's great to watch, Hutto. Plenty of excitement.
The umpire set the bounce to restart the game. Has a man running for him. He can take off after that handball. Ryan earns a free kick. Moves it by foot. Wilson found some space and marked. Good mark and looks to send it back. With a driving kick. A race for the loose ball. Kicks out of the congestion. Ball off hands. He flicks it over, has it now, gets a quick kick away. The ball rolls across the line. Anything standing out at the moment for you, Gaz?
This is a great game, Hutto, and we can just sit back and enjoy it.
Clears the congestion. Fishuck will be upset with that. Clears the ball from the contest. He delivers with a drop punt. He's excited about that one. Fremantle have kicked back-to-back goals. The Dockers getting the fast start.
Great bit of play that resulted in that goal. That came off the back of some...
The game is back underway.
Fremantle, ruck work needs to be a bit better. Too many of their hit-outs are getting sharked by...
Ball up in the centre square. With the ball now. Okay. My ball, says the umpire. Tap down. McKay quickly onto the boot. The possession caused a turnover. McGovern going for number one. The drop part sails between the big sticks. He loved that one. Carlton are on the ball. We resume hostilities. Darcy aims for his man on the ground. Clean from the half volley. Murphy looks to work it from the turnover. Hughes onto the ball. They can link up now. Hughes throws the ball away. for number one. Hook the kick wide and a behind. The Blues now only trail by five. Hughes ready to bring it back into play. Ryan marks in a ball space. Goes by foot. Steady hands there as he holds that one. Moved on by Akers. Lock elects to kick. Good mark there. Darcy releases the ball. Wilson kicks hurriedly. Brayshaw clears the congestion. Unbelievable. Put that down for Mark of the Year. Akers hammers it at goal. Kick on the way. Pretty happy with that one. Fremantle, 18. Lead Carlton, 7.
He did really well there and gets the reward.
Back with another centre bounce. One it down. Wins the race to the ball. Tucker Campbell's. Brayshaw hacking it out of there. A chance to reload the attack now. Looks to move it by foot. Quickly onto the boot. It's marked by Hogan. So what can Fremantle do with this opportunity in front of goal? He decides to go for home. It's going to be close. They get around him after that effort. 17 points the difference. Back in the middle now. Darcy gets it down. Difficult ball control. Just gave it away. Fife steals possession. Scoops it up. It'll be a free kick for that high tackle. He drives it. Jones found a way to mark that one. 40 metres from home. An ideal position to be kicking from. Kick off the boot, and it sailed through.
Of course, Hunter.
That's the first goal of the day for Jones. He's excited about that one. Gary, how did you see that opening quarter?
The Dockers started well. Now it's time for them to do it for four quarters.
Any thoughts from you, Gaz?
Carlton haven't been able to set up many set shots at goal, but I'm not sure that it's the forward's fault. The ball has been coming in way too slow. You can't expect your forward to kick a winning total that way.
The siren sounds for the start of the second quarter. Thumps it clear, takes possession, has it now, rushes with the kick. Couldn't snaffle it. Kasbov will be the recipient of the free. Going for goal number one. It was always pushing their post and pushing it so hard, it hit it. Nick Guse looking for options now. Finds a target.
Fremantle are allowing too many marks inside the opposition forward 50. If they continue to get beaten in this area, they'll find it difficult to keep the lead.
Doing well to intercept that kick. Mundy landed in his back on this occasion. Going for goal number one. Lucky to even score with that shot. Carlton. Hamlin unsure of the next move. Conker drops the mark. Finding the loose ball was Hill. Fails to fend off the tackler.
A great defensive effort.
Is in his possession. Just searching for a teammate. Takes an uncontested mark.
Fremantle have the lead, but they're allowed plenty of opposition marks inside 50. They need to fix up that aspect of their game if they're to stay on top.
What can you tell us at this stage, Gary?
I'm loving what this game is giving us right now.
Pierce missed an opportunity to mark. Gathered by Walsh. Going for goal number one. He's put it through. He celebrates hard after that. The margin is now under a goal. Darcy clears the contest. Just put it on the boot. Intercepts the ball well. Fisher kicks the ball deep. Picks it up. And now we'll have a ball up. Punches it clear. Gets the loose ball. A bit too hard with a push. And it's a free kick. Plummer puts on a bump. Off the ground. And it's a goal for Hughes. He puts through his first goal. His teammates rush over. Fremantle by 8 points.
They're looking more dangerous inside 50 now. A great reward for effort. The Dockers are setting up really well defensively, and they're able to cut off these attacks with intercept marks like that. The Dockers have been extremely well organised at the stoppages, and it sees them being able to win the ball from the clearance.
He puts it out of bounds on the full. Nunes uses it by foot. Darcy collects the loose ball. The tackle over the shoulder. Pittenett goes with the kick. Dow has a great set of hands. Puts boot to ball. Simpson has it. Got boot to ball. Picked up by Walsh. Able to release the kick. Nunes tries his luck at goal. Just sneaks in from behind. The Blues reduce the margin, considering the options on the kick-in. Ryan with an easy mark. Chose to kick it. Takes a simple grab. Good mark and looks to send it back.
Fremantle can allow too many marks inside the opposition forward 50. If they continue to get beaten in this area, they'll find it difficult to keep the lead.
Got hands to it. He's got the football now. Hits the target by hand. Martin took his eyes off the ball. Blakely wins the foot race. Nice mark under pressure. Converting these opportunities could make a big difference to today's result. And the mark will be paid 20 metres from home. Shaping the kick for the banana. Going for goal number two. And he's really turning it on now. Look at him, he really enjoyed that one. That's two in a row for Fremantle. The lead is now 13. The ball spills to Murphy. Slams it under the boot. Looks like the ball will be coming back.
Fremantle have the lead, but they're allowing plenty of opposition marks inside 50. They need to fix up that aspect of their game if they're to stay on top.
By Conker. Hughes takes it well. 40 metres from home. Themselves in the second half. They trailed by 19.
Fremantle have controlled the play well and deserve this lead at halftime.
What stands out for you, Gaz?
Carlton can't seem to find the footy. It's pretty simple. If they don't have the ball, they can't score.
Much appreciated, Gaz. We're set to go at the start of the third quarter. Thrashes it. Jones with a clean collect. Goes by hand. Murphy gets on the end of that handball. He's got the footy in his hands. What are your thoughts at the moment, Gaz?
This is a classic game we're seeing right now.
Darcy won himself a free. Decides to kick. Petrevski-Seaton gets the loose ball. The ball finds Casbolt. 40 metres out. Going for goal number one. He's missed it. Unable to make any inroads there. Carlton behind by eight. Hamlin considering the options on the kicking. The ball ends up going to ground. Has to do better than that in the mark contest. Cruiser searches for a teammate downfield. A chance to reload the attack now. Channels a long kick. The ball ends up with Walters. Misses his pace. Looking to kick goal number two. It's a poor kick, and it hits the behind post. Ended up kicking it into the behind post. The kick from Plowman, marking in space, was out. A spearing kick. Brayshaw slips high and gives away the free kick. Murphy has resources out wide. Ball spills. I haven't seen him for a while, Gaz.
Well, he hasn't had the impact we were expecting.
He wins the ball in the air. This will certainly test him from this distance. Going for goal number one. The kick towards goal. The drop punt goes straight between the big sticks. This kick has extended their lead. Smiles all round. About to resume play. Winning it was Ryan. Just gets the kick away. Ball ends up with the opposition. The loose ball scooped up. Brayshaw clears the congestion. Cruiser drives the kick. Landed in his back on this occasion. Collier going for distance with the kick. Winning the ball in the air was Long. Going for goal number one. On its way. The top one falls between the big sticks. Look at them celebrate that effort. That's five in a row for Fremantle. Fremantle by five goals. Guides it down. Tucker clears the ball from the contest. Stands tall and marks. Puts it on the boot. Over the top of the pack.
Well, when you look at the shots at goal, there just hasn't been enough scoring opportunities being created. Get the ball inside 50 and give your forwards a chance to take a mark. Fremantle, forwards are dangerous anywhere inside 50. They just need to be given a shot.
Doesn't take the mark. Now we'll get a ball up. What can you tell us, Gaz?
I'd really love it if these teams took the contest to the next level. Fremantle are getting first use from their ruckman.
Brayshaw puts it into the 50. Takes a nice mark.
Fremantle just aren't running for each other or creating space to work into. And as a result, they haven't been able to earn many set shots inside 50.
Didn't get low enough with the tackle. Elects to kick. He'll get a mop up. He just can't get out of the action. Can't take the mark. A poorly executed tackle there. Looks up with the kick. Pierce collects the loose ball. Finds this one all by himself. A chance to put a second goal on the board. Offline from behind. Now they lead by 30. Jones laying up the options now. Plowman couldn't hang on to the ball. Lock gets onto the ball. Umpire calls for the ball. Lock got the tap. He gets his hands on the footy. We'll have another ball up. Tap came from Lob. Now we've got a ball up. Lock just swats it away. There'll be a ball up close to goal. Slapped away. He has the ball. Walsh hacks it out of there. Finds a bit of room to mark. Gaz, what do you think of that?
Fremantle believe they can win this game. It's time to show it.
Both sides finding plenty of scoring opportunities that term. Anything to add, Gaz?
Fremantle are on top but are losing the contested possession count. It's one area of their game that needs some work.
Thank you, Gaz. We have one quarter of footy ahead of us. Let's go.
Oh, they've got to take some risks now. They can't afford to waste any time.
Kicks hurriedly. Does well to cut off the kick. Goes by foot. An easy grab for Martin.
Fremantle haven't been able to set up many set shots at goal, but I'm not sure that it's the forward's fault. The ball has been coming in way too slow. You can't expect your forward to kick a winning total that way.
Collected by Cripps. Darcy found time to get it on the boot. Finding the ball with ease. Chera just too high with the tackle. He gives chase to the footy. He wins possession. Nunes comes away with the ball. What can you tell us at this stage, Gary?
I'd love for the coach to send a message out there and tell these players to take the game on.
Good body work to win the mark. Not sure if he has the journey from here. Heads it inside 50. Hamlin picks up the loose ball. Likes his chances from here. Hacking it out of there. Ends up turning this ball over. Pittman elects to kick. A strong mark in the pack from Kurno. He's the number one ranked player on the ground.
The opposition need to get a hold of him.
Move it on. Go for goal number one. That kick goes offline. They would have loved to get... That'd be...
Fremantle have turned the ball over a lot trying to play aggressively. It's where they turn it over which doesn't make it as dangerous.
Decides to go. Got boot to ball. Coughed up by Bye. Just sends it into space. Turned it over. Nobody can hold on here. Avoids the pressure. It's cut off by Blakely. He gains possession. Brilliant tackle and wins it.
Great tackle.
Martin gets the opportunity to have a shot for goal. He's a long way from home, but he might have the wheels. They are desperate for a goal now. Drifts wide to go through for a behind. Can't make Carlton. Players move as they look to provide an option. Doing well with the mark. Dow sends it into space. Pierce slams it onto the boot. Fisher looks in need of a spell. Lob just through it. Spears the ball, just landed in his back. Moves the ball along the wing. Hogan got up, but couldn't bring it down. Taking a nice grab. Simpson moves it now. He takes the mark.
Well, when you look at the shots at goal, there just hasn't been enough scoring opportunities being created. Get the ball inside 50 and give your forwards a chance to take a mark. Fremantle forwards are dangerous anywhere inside 50. They just need to be given a shot.
Law takes it strongly. He slams it towards goal. What a sensational goal. Another goal. He's kicked a couple now. Congratulated by his teammates. That is six in a row for the Dockers. They continue to push this lead out. Kurno spills it. I haven't seen him for a while, Gaz.
He needs to find a way into this game. Beautiful tackle, Hutto.
We'll get a ball up on the wing. Anything standing out at the moment for you, Gaz?
This game needs a spark at the moment.
Lob just threw it. Great grab. Simpson channels a long kick. Silvani looks to get onto the football. Hunts it down by Hughes.
Great attack on the ball carrier.
Not long to go before the end of the match. Hughes gets the ball. He's got the footy in his hands. Uses it now. Over the top of the pack. 25 metres out. The kick will be from a 45 degree angle. And that kick goes offline. They're really struggling in front of goal. Not their best performance. Carlton will be searching for improvement for their next game. Gaz, what did you make of the result?
Just a fantastic performance from Fremantle. They really put in the hard yards and they can enjoy the result.
The final score of the match is Fremantle 10-1-61. Carlton 3-9-27. Thanks to Gary Lyon for joining us. We'll see you all later.
Thanks, Hutto. Until next time.
Welcome, Anthony Hudson with you. Coming to you live from Optus Stadium. And joining me as always is Gary Lyon.
Hey, Hutto, today's an exciting match.
Today's match between the Eagles and Fremantle. Run on in full confidence, they're looking sharp, and the crowd are appreciating it. I'm really looking forward to seeing how they play today.
Good call, Hutto. Today's game will be decided by the Fremantle defence. If they can create intercept plays and stop the scoring, they'll win this game.
Captain onto the field of play. The banners are ready for the fires. Colors share the West Coast sky. I will to win, we'll never die. We're the Eagles, we're the West Coast Eagles. And we're here to show you why. The captains converge for the toss of the coin. West Coast wins the toss. Both sides look ready to get into the action just moments away now. Swanson takes possession. Just gets it onto the boot. Kennedy grabs that one. Lining up for goal. He goes for broke. A good result there, and that's a goal for West Coast. That's his first. He acknowledges the crowd. He's kicked the first goal.
Some great ball movement there. He just knew they were going to score. This is how they can score.
Clears the contest. Law controls this one. It'll be a ball up. Can you tell us anything at the moment, Gaz?
I'm loving what this game is giving us right now. Great tackling there, Hutto.
Slams it onto the boot. Finding the loose ball was Walters. They can create from this. Matera gets it away under pressure. Oh, just hits the post. Fremantle can ride in this contest now. Ball up close to the boundary. Taps it down. He has the ball. The umpire will ping him for deliberate. Brayshaw sets his sights on the goals. Deciding to go around the corner. Through for a point. Matera had it, lost it. Fremantle now only trailed by four. Weighing up the options now. Mark Bikes Schofield gets a hand to the ball. Conker dug out the loose ball. Going for goal number one. Matera is missed. The Dockers behind by three. Venables with the kicking duties. Ends up marking uncontested. Kick by Cole. Found space for an easy mark. Just gets a hand in. Shepherd takes it well. Gathered by Matera. And the chance at goal is taken by Fremantle. That will settle his nerves. Gets his first on the ball. Gets some reward for his efforts. Darling just slaps it down. He lays off the pass. Collects the loose ball. Jetta won himself a free. Stabs at the kick. Open opportunity for Shepherd. Did well to get a hand in. Hutchings was taken high in the tackle. It's a foot race to get this one. Just got the hands in the back there. The kick from Nelson. Takes the mark all by himself. Spills the mark. Redden looking a bit sluggish out there. Hill takes the mark. Executes the taunt. He gets above the crowd. Moves the ball by foot. Darcy got under it. Wouldn't want to miss these opportunities. Can he put it through? Kick on the line. He's enjoying that goal. Darley aims for his man on the ground. Handballs. The handball hits the target. Has it now. Gets a quick kick away. Marks now and can send it back. Waterman manufactures a handball. Kicks hurriedly. Finds this one all by himself. 45 metres out. Walters going for number one. Sends it home. Look at him. He really enjoyed that one. Fremantle with the ascendancy over West Coast, leading 21-6. Missed the target. The loose ball picked up. Scoops up the ball. Uses the hands instead of the body, and it's a free kick. Cripps gets on the end of this. Decides to kick. McCarthy wins the ball in the air. Packs it out of there. Hogan did well to win that ball. Just threw the ball. Shepherd puts it on the boot. Off hands from Nelson. Is accepted. Just a moment. Fremantle starting to exert some dominance now. Looking to bring it back into play. Plays on from the kick in. Puts boot to ball. Marks all alone. Uses it by foot. Great grab. One quarter down and three to go. Plenty of football still to be played. The scores are Fremantle 22, West Coast 6.
Fremantle came out and started well. They deserved the lead at quarter time.
What do the stats tell us, Gaz?
West Coast are getting beaten around the contest. Rectifying that problem is key to them gaining control of this match.
The siren sounds for the start of the second quarter. Wins the ruck duel. Kelly did well not to fumble. Chera drives it out of the pack. Doesn't waste any time. Walters goes for territory. Shrugs the tackle. Dishes it off to a player on the run. The umpire calls for a stoppage. What do you make of the game so far, Gary?
There's some great skills on display right now. Great match.
Easily takes the mark. He drives it. Darley doesn't take the mark. Drives it out of the pack. Great mark in the pack.
Fremantle haven't been able to set up many set shots at goal, but I'm not sure that it's the forward's fault. The ball has been coming in way too slow. You can't expect your forward to kick a winning total that way.
With quick hands. Walter couldn't be happier with that goal. That's four in a row for Fremantle. Now they lead by 22. Darling thumped it clear. Releases it under pressure. Ryan gathers it now. McCarthy clinks up with a chance to run. Schofield collects it. Wants to keep it moving. Just put it on the boot. Off hands. He gives away a free for in the back. Looks to move it by foot. Archie runs after this one. Ryan with a big fist on it. He's got the football now. Mundy wins the foot race. Hutchings with the ball. At full stride, receives the handball. Clears the contest. The ball spills to Kelly. The umpire will ball it up.
Hammers it.
Opportunity for Mundy.
We'll get a ball up.
Ryan won the hit out. The umpire calls for it. Punches it clear. Ryan
onto the ball.
Hacks it on the boot. He takes aim. Just couldn't get it to curve enough. West Coast close the gap to 21. Deciding where to go with the kick in. Plays on. Goes with the kick. Clean pickup by Cripps.
Brilliant chase.
Hill
on the move now.
Gone! What a tackle! Jetta puts the tackle on Hill.
Big tackle.
He has to hold on to those. Dug out the loose ball. Hands that ball to the opposition. Now we will get a ball up. What do you make of the game so far, Gary?
There's not enough effort out there at the minute.
Has to do better than that in the mark contest. Brayshaw quickly onto the boot. He drives it towards goal. He delivers for the drop pass. Gets his first. And that puts them further in front. Brayshaw getting the crowd involved. Fremantle with a handy break. They lead West Coast 34-7. Goes by hand to Darling. Picked up by Hutchings. Gives it, don't argue. Sinks the slipper into it.
Well, when you look at the shots at goal, there just hasn't been enough scoring opportunities being created. Get the ball inside 50 and give your forwards a chance to take a mark. Fremantle, forwards are dangerous anywhere inside 50. They just need to be given a shot.
Oh, what a hanger there! Walters not wasting time. Elects to play on. That's holding the ball!
Constant pressure and rewarded.
Pierce determined to reach the ball. Thumps it clear. Under pressure and keeps it alive. Schofield uses it by foot. Gets it out of congestion. Finds a target. He gets his hands on the footy. Half time arrives, Gary. What are your thoughts on the first half?
A good first half from...
Let's analyse the stats.
Fremantle have to be smarter with their ball use at times. At the moment, they're turning it over in the air too regularly for their liking.
Thanks for that. It'll be interesting to see what changes these... The third quarter has begun. Thrashes it. Kennedy with clean hands for a difficult bouncing ball. Cox runs onto the field. The umpire calls for it. What can you tell us, Gaz?
I'm waiting for something to change the way this game is going right now.
There'll be a ball up in the centre square. Lob thrashes it. Sherrick doesn't get low enough and gives away the free. He takes the mark. Elects to keep moving. Shee kicks it. A chance to reload the attack now. Gets a hand to the ball. Ball picked up. Cripps thumps it towards goal. It looked impossible, but he made it work. Look at them celebrate that effort. Thumped by Fardy. The tackle deserves a free and gets it. Yo, under pressure now.
Fantastic tackle.
Marks now and can send it back.
Fremantle just aren't running for each other or creating space to work into. And as a result, they haven't been able to earn many set shots inside 50.
Hughes gets a quick kick away. Jetta didn't mark it. Intervening brilliantly was Hogan. Matera gets the loose ball. Receives the handball and takes off.
Finding the ball with ease.
Congratulated by his teammates. Fremantle go to West Coast by 27. Lock with the punch. Kicks in heavy traffic. Akers gets on the end of this.
Fremantle, for allowing too many marks in inside the opposition 450. If they continue to get beaten in this area, they'll find it difficult to keep the lead.
Can't take possession.
I haven't seen him for a while, Gaz.
Yeah, he's barely touched the ball, Hunter.
Cox just landed in his back. Hogan there to mop up. It's a turnover. Manufactures the handball. He can take off after that handball. Swanson did well to control the ball. Walters just too high with the tackle. Chose to kick it. Intercepts the ball well. Nelson takes the mark uncontested. He spears the ball. Nice hands. Slams it on the boot. Oh, he did everything right except take the mark. Finding the loose ball was Cripps. Finding the ball was Pierce. Tough ball to handle. McCarthy on the ball. Takes on the space. He might kick a goal. The drop punt goes straight between the big sticks. He's enjoying that goal. Fremantle have kicked the last two goals. The lead is now 33. Lock on the tap. Picks up the loose ball. The ball spills from the tackle. Hacking it out of there. A good job keeping it in play there. Goes through for a behind. 34. Venables assessing the options. Cole marks uncontested. With a driving kick. Has to do better than that in the mark contest. Cripps keeping it low. Finds himself in space and marks.
Fremantle haven't been able to set up many set shots at goal, but I'm not sure that it's the forward's fault. The ball has been coming in way too slow. You can't expect your forward to kick a winning total that way.
Bach gives away a free for in the back. 50 metres out. Going for goal number one. No luck for him there, and it's a behind. Margin in a really tricky situation. Unsure of their next move. Walters was surrounded. He needed to mark it, and he did. Moves it by foot. Long, not getting much of it, Gaz.
He's barely touched the ball lately.
The handball now from Yo. Ball gets cut off. Movement by hand. Hurried kick. Picked off the deck. Constricted by Blakely.
Coaches love to see that kind of tackling pressure. Fremantle have the lead, but they're allowed plenty of opposition marks inside 50. They need to fix up that aspect of their game if they're to stay on top.
With a driving kick. Dockers 53, plays West Coast 14, a quarter of footy to go.
The Dockers believe they can win this game. It's time to show it.
Any thoughts from you, Gaz?
West Coast need to be far more competitive with their clearance work. They can't win games that way.
Thanks for that, Gaz. Time to find out what happens in this final term.
Oh, they've got to take some risks now. They can't afford to waste any time.
Mundy doesn't make the tackle. The contest, no match for him.
Of course, Hunter.
Kicks the ball deep. Ends up turning this ball over. Chose to kick it. Missed the target. Darcy wins it back. Yo wins the foot race. Quickly onto the boot. He's in charge of the ranking points.
He's the most dominant player on the ground at the moment.
Did well to get a hand in. Gathers it now. The ball mopped up. Mops up the loose ball. Up for grabs for Schofield. Racking up possessions now. She presents and takes the mark.
Well, when you look at the shots at goal, there just hasn't been enough scoring opportunities being created. Get the ball inside 50 and give your forwards a chance to take a mark. Fremantle forwards are dangerous anywhere inside 50. They just need to be given a shot.
He looks like he needs a spell. Picked up under pressure. Just gets it onto the boot. Kennedy goes off the deck and nails the goal. West Coast convert in a time of desperate need. He acknowledges the crowd. Won the hit out. He gains possession. Natanui. Hurried kick. Good mark. And looks to send it back. Blakely goes with the kick. Does well to cut off the kick. Kicks to the square. He couldn't hang on. Finds the loose ball. Natanui sends it clear of the contest. Using every ounce of energy he has left. Takes a strong mark. A low stabbing kick. What a beauty.
Strong hands.
Cripps with a chance to line up for goal. Should be simple from here. The fans hoping this one goes through to give them a glimmer of hope.
Let's go! Let's go!
He celebrates hard after that. That's two in a row for West Coast. Starting to work their way back. Punched away. Kelly kicks out of the congestion. Drops the ball. The ball's supposed to Hughes. Hughes will be the recipient of the free. Drives the kick hard. Blakely gets in a good position. Moves the ball by foot. She needs a chance to rest. Can you tell us anything at the moment, Gaz?
I'd love for the coach to send a message out there and tell these players to take the game on.
Just set up for an incredible leap.
Strong mark.
Goes with the tour. Couldn't complete the mark.
I haven't seen him for a while, Gaz.
That's right, Hutto. He just can't seem to get into the game. Showing some really good pressure there.
Fantastic chase and tackle. Didn't get away from that tackle.
Great tackle.
Doing well to intercept that kick. Clears the danger for now. Spent that one before he earned it.
I haven't seen him for a while, Gaz.
Well, he hasn't had the impact we were expecting.
He gives it a ride. That one will really lift him.
Yes, Hutto.
He loved that one. Fremantle, Govic, West Coast, 5:33. Natanui does well. Five brings it out of the pack. Rushes with the kick. Archie, the better man there. Tips it towards half forward. The mark has been taken. 45 metres out. Natanui is blowing hard after that effort. You can see that happening right after it left his boot. Hamling to kick it in. Fremantle victorious. Gary, what did you think of today's game?
It's pretty simple. One team played for four quarters and the opposition just couldn't go there.
Final scores are 9-5-59 to 4-3-27. On behalf of Gary Lyon, thank you for joining us. We'll see you again soon.
Hello and welcome. I'm Anthony Hudson. Thanks for joining us for Saturday Afternoon Football. Bringing you all the action today from Marvel Stadium. With me in the box for this match will be Gary Lyon. Welcome, Gaz.
Hi, Hutto. Today should be a great match.
Today we have the Bombers coming up against Fremantle. Set to run through them.
Well, we could be in for a scrappy game here. Both sides have been pretty good defensively of late. It's which defensive method stacks up better.
They run on in full confidence. They're looking sharp, and the crowd are appreciating it. The cheer squad's hard work is paying off. The Banners are looking great. The captains of both sides make their way to the middle for the coin toss. Kicking to the left of screen, round one, and the start of the home and away season.
Round one is always different. It's a fresh start and a chance for these sides to prove themselves early in the season.
Players head to their positions as we prepare for the opening bounce. It's a big clash in the middle to start this one. Thump clear. This is Brayshaw. Finds a bit of room to mark. A thumping torpedo. Bellchamber's got hands to it. Goes for the goals. Takes an uncontested mark. 15 metres out. Looking to bring this around the body. Walters couldn't quite nail the kick. Fremantle, but Bellchamber's with the responsibility of kicking it in. It's a turnover. McCarthy couldn't snaffle it. Walters unloads one towards goal. No issues with that drop punt. They get around him after that effort. Puts the first goal on the board. Thrashes it. Opportunity for Mundy. Heffel throws the ball away. Moved on by Collier. Gleeson wins the marking contest. It's a long kick. Strong mark in the contest. Chips it towards half forward. It's cut off by Mundy. Ball up call. What can you tell us at this stage, Gary?
I'm liking what I'm seeing at the moment, Hutto. A great game of footy.
One it down. Here's Heffel. Darcy with the intercept. Handball's out in front. Has a runner alongside him. Francis receives the ball. Gets a quick kick away. Fantasia takes the mark. Uncontested. Fantasia one out in the square. A chance to gather the ball. Darcy gets the loose ball. McCarthy controlling the airwaves on this occasion. Moves it by foot. Marking in space was Hawks. Go for goal number one. It's going to be close. He's excited about that one. Fremantle have kicked back-to-back goals. Fremantle with a dream start. Darcy with a hit. Laying a strong tackle.
Fantastic pressure there. Beautiful tackle, Hutto.
Now we've got a ball up. Tap down. Practicing some fancy moves. Gleeson throws the ball away. Chips it towards half forward. Collier couldn't keep his hands on it. Narrowly avoids the tackle. Clumsy tackle results in a free kick. Gleeson uses it by foot, takes the mark. Saad puts it on the boot. McKenna takes the mark. Decides to kick, gets into a good position to take that. Goes by foot. Dug it out. McKenna with quick hands. Cutler just put it on the boot. Collected by Scheel. Slams it onto the boot. Ball hits the deck. Pierce there to mop up. Hill just threw it. Looks up with a kick. The ball knocked out of the tackle. Sockers it forward. Cleanly picked up. Cutler now heading to the bench for a break. And now we'll have a ball up. What are your thoughts at the moment, Gaz?
This is a classic game we're seeing right now.
The umpire will ball it up. Lobb dumps it clear. Pierce hunting with authority.
Coaches love to see that kind of tackling pressure.
Rushes with the kick. Ambrose with an easy mark. Ambrose one out in the square. Found space for an easy mark. Just gave it away. Walter just threw it. Chips it towards half forward. He's kicked the goal. He put through his first goal. Gets some reward for his efforts. Essendon sink their first.
That goal will be a real confidence boost. You can see he's up and about now.
Back in the middle. Slapped away. A bit too hard with the push, and it's a free kick. A strong pack mark. Stringer drives the kick. Doing well with the mark. Essendon with a lot to think about as they trail by 7.
Fremantle could come out and started well and show them they have what it takes. The coach will be asking for more of the same for the rest of this one.
Let's have a closer look at the stats.
Fremantle are falling behind in the contested possessions. They don't want to give the opposition a chance to get back into it.
Thank you, Gaz. We're ready for second quarter action. Back in the middle as the Rucks go at it. Punched away.
I'll have it.
There'll be a ball up in the centre square. Anything standing out at the moment for you, Gaz?
I'm really enjoying this one, Hutto.
Just put his hands in the back of the opponent and it's a free. Francis dishes it off. He wins possession, is in his possession with the ball now. Mundy earns a free kick. Looks to move it by foot. McDonald, Tip and Woody found a way to mark that one. Stewart wins the ball in the air. You'd expect this one to sail through the middle. He decides to go for home, and he's missed. Essendon reduced the margin, ready to bring it back into play. Hangs onto that one. Gets onto that torpedo. Flew high, but didn't hold on. Phillips got the hands free. There'll be a ball up in the centre square. Clears the contest. Has it now. Ryan gets the ball out of heavy traffic. Matera elects to kick. Hurley couldn't snaffle it. Akers going for number one. That is a stunning goal.
Freo! Freo!
Sell- lead for Fremantle. Umpire ready to resume play. Swanson, he has the ball. Finds his man, uses the bump, contests the hard ball. Moved on by Brayshaw. Cutler got hands to it. McDonald, Tip and Woody picks up the loose ball. Wilson flicks it over. Doing well was Bryan. Heppel dug out the loose ball. Gets into some space to mark this. Got boot to ball. Brayshaw runs after the ball. Stands tall and marks.
Moving on.
He has to play on now. A strong pack mark. Gleeson went out in the square. Great mark under pressure. Dishes it off. He wins possession. Is in his possession. Smith puts another one through. Pretty happy with that one. Essendon close the gap to six.
That's a really good team ball. Essendon haven't been able to get the ball forward enough to score. They need to get some repeat entries inside 50 to generate some scoring.
Play on.
Ambrose rushes with the kick. Ryan gets in the way. Hogan gets on the end of this. Decides to go with the barrel. He flies high. Oh, what a mark! Normally a pretty good kick. Let's see what he can do here. He likes his chances from here. A drop punt through the goal. He's got a couple now. Starting to get into this game. His teammates rush over. Centre bounce. Bellchambers with a big fist on it. He's got the football now. He's got the footy in his hands. Arches his boot now. This is kickable by his standards. Normally a good shot on goal. Hook the kick wide and behind. Fremantle Clee is now 13. Bell Chambers to bring it back into play. Goes with the kick. Smith couldn't hang on to the ball. Ryan doesn't make the tackle. It'll be a ball up. Can you tell us anything at the moment, Gaz?
This is a great game, Hutto, and we can just sit back and enjoy it.
Fantasia gets the ball. With the ball now. They can create from this. Puts on a big hit. Intercepted. Quickly onto the boot. Ends up marking uncontested. Puts it on the boot. A big contested grab. Testing shot outside 50. Time and it's Fremantle 26 to Essendon 13.
Fremantle will go into the rooms at halftime with plenty of confidence and back themselves for the second half.
Here's Gary to take a look at the key stats.
The Bombers can't having trouble winning the ball, they just need to use it more effectively to get into a winning position.
Much appreciated, Gaz. Two quarters down and only two to go. Players back on the field to begin the second half here. Big thump from Darcy. The bounce made it tough for Vine. Gleeson didn't mark it. Shield dominating this game.
He's been superb today, Hutto.
That's something to smile about. Vine couldn't be happier with that goal. Fremantle have kicked the last two goals. The margin is 19. Takes possession. Francis is streaming past and gets the footy. Just releases the ball. He gets his hands on the footy. Zaharakis keeps coming. He just throws that ball. Saad found some space and marked. He drives it. Marks that ball uncontested. Hurry kick. Matera had it, lost it. Needs a bit of a rest. Francis marks it.
The Dockers just aren't running for each other or creating space to work into. And as a result, they haven't been able to earn many set shots inside 50.
slams it on the boot. Stringer used the body to take that mark. The ball is turned over. Couldn't quite with the mark. Akers kicks hurriedly. Ball gets cut off. Blinking by hand. Heppel clinks up with a chance to run. Outruns the tackler. Hands that ball to the opposition. Smith decides to soccer it. He looks like he needs a spell. Hits the post, and it's a behind. Hamling deciding where to go with the kick here. Blakely with the mark.
Fremantle, Kerr allowing too many marks inside the opposition forward 50. If they continue to get beaten in this area, they'll find it difficult to keep the lead.
Hughes moves it now. Ball collected. Just got a hand to that one. Searching for a teammate. Cox shot up, but couldn't bring it down. I haven't seen him for a while, Gaz.
Yeah, he's barely touched the ball, have he?
Zaharakis won himself a free. The mark is taken by Cox. Gets onto a massive kick. Shuffled up by Walters. Drops the mark. I haven't seen him for a while, Gaz.
Maybe the coach needs to get on the phone to him and give him some instructions.
That's holding the ball.
Big tackle.
He takes the shot. On its way. Just sneaks in from behind. Fremantle. Bell Chambers looking to bring it back into play. Zaharakis presents and takes the mark.
Fremantle just aren't running for each other or creating space to work into. And as a result, they haven't been able to earn many set shots inside 50.
Looks like the ball will be coming back. Smiles all round. Now they lead by 20.
It hasn't always been clean, but they've got the goal.
Back in the middle to resume play. Thump clear. He gains possession. McDonald Tippin Woody uses the body well. Going for goal number one. Touched over the line. Considering the options on the kick in. Marked by Wilson. Uses it now. Does well to cut off the kick. Gleeson goes the long option. Five doesn't quite with the leap. McKenna hacking it out of there. Townsend going for number one. Look at him. He really enjoyed that one. Trouble for Bessenden. They need to kick a few now.
Great bit of play that resulted in that. Essendon got actually on top in the contested positions. They just need to convert that dominance into scoreboard pressure.
Ball up in the centre square. What can you tell us at this stage, Gary?
It's a really entertaining game of football.
My ball, says the umpire. Hammers it. The umpire calls for the ball now. Fremantle leading by 17 as we go to the final turn.
Fremantle fans will be hoping they can hold on and get a memorable victory today.
Time to see if there's anything interesting in the stats.
Essendon have turned it over too often today. They aren't coping with the pressure. They should try and slow it down and control the ball for a moment.
Thanks, Gaz. One quarter of footy to go.
They need to get a move on if they're going to win from here.
Thumps it clear. Showed good control. Couldn't get the hand pass away, so he just threw it. Offhands from Cox. He slams it towards goal. Intercepts the ball very well.
Fremantle have the lead, but they're allowed plenty of opposition marks inside 50. They need to fix up that aspect of their game if they're to stay on top. Hold on to the ball for a few moments and just take the sting out of the game.
Brayshaw wants to keep it moving by hand. Receives the handball and takes off. Looks like the ball will be coming back. Collier elects to kick it long. Coughed up by Conker. Well, punches it clear. Conker runs over. Clears the contest. Elects to kick. Simply outplayed his opponent.
Fremantle are allowing too many marks inside the opposition forward 50. If they continue to get beaten in this area, they'll find it difficult to keep the lead.
He's in charge of the ranking points.
He is dominating this game.
The scoreboard starting to worry Essendon now. Conker gathers it now. Gathered by Cutler. Slick with the hands. Stewart looking to put through another goal. He just nailed that one. That's two in a row for Essendon. Just two goals in it. Phillips gets onto the ball. Sends it clear of the contest. Winning the ball in the air was Stewart. Almost directly in front here. Wasting opportunities in front of just under two goals.
Fremantle have actually turned it over more than the opposition, but they haven't allowed that to translate into scores. It's why they're still in front.
Heppel, there'll be a ball up in the centre square.
A critical stage of this one.
Hammers it. Akers elects the loose ball. Clear free, just put both hands in the back. A chance to reload the attack now.
Fremantle haven't been able to set up many set shots at goal, but I'm not sure that it's the forward's fault. The ball has been coming in way too slow. You can't expect your forward to kick a winning total that way.
Cutler going for number one. It's only a behind. Once again, they can't convert it to the scoreboard. Essendon behind by eight, looking to bring it back into play. Fantasia couldn't keep his hands on it. He's worked hard and probably needs a chance to rest. Ambrose moves it by hand. Picks up the loose ball. Strong mark in the contest. Uses it by foot. He has the ball. Slips the tackle. Cutler lobs the handball. Is in his possession. Ambrose is streaming past and gets the footy. Collier picks it up. He wins the ball in the air. Ryan gets the handball away. Dishes it off to a player on the run. Kicks hurriedly. Now it's a ball up. Punches it clear. The loose ball picked up. Ryan just gets it onto the boot. Drifts wide to go through for a behind. Fremantle lead by nine. Bell Chambers players move as they look to provide an option. Oh, he did everything right except take the mark. Hurley collects it. It's been turned over. Linking by hand. Might be a bit of an injury for Pearce. Gary, what do you think it is?
Yeah, definitely something wrong here. He's trying to get off the ground as quick as he can.
McCarthy missed an opportunity to mark. Hogan celebrating hard. The umpire set to bounce to restart the game. Heppel moves it by hand, and now they're away. Danaher doesn't take the mark. I haven't seen him for a while, Gaz.
He needs to find a way into this game.
Brilliant chase. He bangs it through. Smith with the second goal. Congratulated, boys.
This is how they can score big, Hutto. If they can do that on a consistent basis, it's massive.
And now it's a ruckus. McKenna wins the ball in the air.
Well, when you look at the shots at goal, there just hasn't been enough scoring opportunities being created. Get the ball inside 50 and give your forwards a chance to take a mark. Fremantle forwards are dangerous anywhere inside 50. They just need to be given a shot. Lots of pressure out there at the minute.
Parrish misses the tackle. And there it is. Fremantle win, and their fans are certainly happy about it. Gary, any final thoughts?
There are things both sides can take out of this game, but ultimately there's only one group of supporters that go home happy.
Thanks for that. Final scores are 7-4, 46 to 5-7, 37. Thanks for joining us, Gaz, but that's all we have time for.
It's been a pleasure, Hutto, and we'll catch you next time. And if we get up, we'll do it again.